Hello again and welcome back to our course on Access 2013. In this section we're going to start to look at queries. And first of all I'd like to explain a couple of the reasons why we use queries. Now let's suppose that we'd built up our movies database, we'd added thousands and thousands of movies, thousands and thousands of actors and many other types of information. It's very unlikely that anybody at any one time would want all of that information. They may want a certain amount of information about all movies. For instance, they may want a count of how many of the movies in our database originated in the United States, how many of them were from Italy, how many from New Zealand. They may also want a lot of information about one specific movie, or perhaps all the movies of a particular director. But the common theme in all of these things is that there is usually some element of selection of the information. Either we want a particular movie, perhaps movies from a particular country, perhaps movies by a particular director, or maybe just a particular movie with a particular name. Now this is where queries come in, because queries enable us to look for something subject to a virtually unlimited number of criteria. So for example, if I wanted all of the movies by a particular director that were released between two particular years, and that was say produced in Italy, then I would use a query to find that information. So that's one of the main reasons for using queries. The second main reason we've already seen to some extent when we've looked at this actor maintenance form. Because in the actor maintenance form we have this strange situation at the bottom with this subform where we've got a movie number but not the name of the movie because of the way we've set the data up. Now there's nothing wrong with the way we've set the data up, by the way, but the problem is that you need information on this form from a number of places. You need some information from the actor table, you need some information from the movie table, even some from the country table or the genre table may be needed sometimes, and of course as we extended this database we'd have more tables and maybe need more data from those other tables. So the other thing that queries do is to enable us to get information from many different tables and present it together so that we can correctly represent the information in things like this subform. And in fact it's on the principle of queries that we will make this subform work correctly. So let's start with creation of a straightforward query. Go to the Create tab. And we're going to go into Query Design. There is a Query Wizard, but I want to start with Query Design. And when you click on Query Design, you get two windows. You get a window representing the query itself, which gets a default name, in this case, Query 1. And then in front of that, you get a dialog box, Show Table. And basically the principle here is that you first of all specify which tables you want to get data from. And there may be one, there may be more than one table, and having done that, you close this window, the Show Table window, and then you build the query in the other window. Now the other window is generally referred to as the Query Designer. So let's start by choosing just one table to begin with. Let's choose the movie table. So click on Add. Now we can close this. Now, if I wanted to run a query that would just get the titles of all the movies, this is how I'd do it. If I select the title field, I can drag it down to the grid at the bottom, and in this grid, the top row is the name of a field. And the second row is the name of the table the field is in. So the table is Tuple Movie and the field is Title. Now that on its own is a query. And if I want to run the query, on the ribbon there is now a Design tab. It's the Query Tools Design tab. And in the left hand group, the Results group, there is a Run button. So if I click on Run, it will actually run the query. And what I see as a result of running the query is in datasheet view a list of the titles in my database. Now note that the titles are in the order that they appear in the database, so they are in effectively movie ID order. That is a very simple query, but it's done exactly what I wanted it to do. A query is another database object, so let's suppose for the moment that I've finished working on this query. Of course I haven't. If I close it, click on the close button on the right. Do you want to save changes to the design of the query? Yes, I do. Let's give it a name. I'm just going to call it Query 90s Movies. You'll see what I mean by that in a moment. I'm going to call the query that. Click on OK. Let's open up the navigation pane, and now we've got a new section, a new category in the navigation pane: tables, queries and forms. So the database is beginning to grow. So let's right click on Query 90s Movies and go back into design view. Now I'm going to add another field to this query. The field I'm going to add is year of release. Drag it down into the second column in the query grid at the bottom. And when you're working on a query, there are actually three views. If you look at the design tab here on the left, to the left of that run button, there's a view button, and there are three views. One view, the one we're looking at the moment, is design view. Datasheet view is the one where we see the results of running the query. So let's look at datasheet view. Now I've got the title and the year of release, and then the other view is SQL view. Now if you're not familiar with SQL, SQL stands for Structured Query Language, and it's a pretty much standard universal querying language for relational databases. And what you see here is a statement that describes this query, and the SQL statement is select TuppleMovie.title, TuppleMovie.year of release, which is basically saying the title field in the TuppleMovie table and the year of release field in the TuppleMovie table from the TuppleMovie table. That is a very, very simple SQL statement, but SQL statements are an absolutely fundamental part of relational databases in general and Access in particular. So we've got three views of our query. We've got the design view using the query designer, we've got the SQL view, and we've got the datasheet view. And the datasheet view, of course, shows us the results of running the query. Now when you're working on queries, you may initially find you use design view quite a bit, but as you get to grips with SQL, with SQL, you may often find it's quicker and easier to use SQL statements. So let's look at some of the power of queries now and extend this query a little bit. I'm going to go back into design view, and if you look again at the grid at the bottom, the third row says sort. And what I'm going to do is to add a sort to this query, and the sort is going to be added to the year of release column. If I click in there, a little drop down appears on the right. I'm going to choose ascending, and I'm going to go to the SQL view. Let's look at what the SQL view says. It says what it did before, select the same things from the table, but then it says order by year of release, TuppleMovie.year of release. Let's look at the results. Let's look at datasheet view. And what I now find is that the movies are sorted by their year of release. And again, let's go back into design view. And in the year of release column, let's change it from ascending to descending. Look at the results of that in datasheet view. Obviously the most recent movies are now at the beginning of the list. And if I go back into SQL view, I can see that it says order by year of release DESC desk. It just means descending. Now, for each data type, there is a default when you do order by. In the case of year, which is a number, the default order will be ascending, so you don't need to say ascending if it is ascending, but if you need descending, then you just put in DESC for descending. So now let's go back into the design view again. This time what I'm going to do is to select the movies that were released in the 1990s. Now we've already seen how to put something here in the sort row. Further down there is a criteria row. And if I put in a criterion like greater than 1989, that will give me all the movies 1990 or later. So let's try that one. Review the data sheet. And we've got movies. The oldest one there is Goodfellas 1990. But now let's see how we get the ones that were just in the 1990s. Now we can do that in a couple of ways, but let's just say that we want to say that it's greater than 1989 but less than 2000. So let's go back into design view again and let's click in here and say and less than 2000, and let's see what we get. And of course we get the movies that were just released in the 1990s. So let's have a look at the SQL statements. Select title from table movie, year of release from table movie, etc. where the year of release is greater than 1989 and the year of release is less than 2000. Now this notation is very important. This little dot operator here, table movie dot year of release, something before a dot is the name of a table and something after the dot is the name of the field. So it's a familiar notation that you should get used to. It's the year of release field in the movie table, year of release field in the movie table, and here we have a pair of criteria in what's called a where clause. A where clause is basically a way of selecting data. So we're saying get the movies out of the movie table where the year of release is greater than 1989 and it's less than 2000, and then order by the year of release. The select statement, the SQL statement, is getting more complex, but you will quite often have statements that are at least as complex as this. And once you get used to the structure of the statement, they're probably a lot easier to understand than they might appear at first. Right, I'm going to add yet another thing to this query now. I'm going to go back into design view. I'm going to choose now the country field. So I'm going to drag the country field down to make a new column in my query. This is going to have a criterion as well. And the criterion I'm going to try is equals, now double quotes, United States. Now you can probably guess what that means. That says I want not only it to be a 1990s film, but I want one where the country is United States. Let's look at the SQL statement first. It's got a bit longer. It's got where the year of release is 1989 and the year of release less than 2000 and the country equals United States. So we've got a pair of criteria related to the year of release, and we've got a criterion related to the country, United States. Let's look at the results of that. There we are. We've actually lost one or two movies, but all the ones we've got, we can see, are United States. Now, if I was running a query like this, but there was actually no point in saying United States, United States, United States all the time, because I know with this query that they're all United States movies. If I go back into design view again, the fourth row in the grid at the bottom is show. And if I uncheck that, the country field is still involved in the query and I can still use the criterion of equals United States. But it's no longer shown. So if I now go into datasheet view, I get all the same movies, but I don't actually see the word United States over and over again in this extra field, the country field, that is actually superfluous within the results of the query. And then finally, let me just go back into SQL view again. I'm going to look at that very last criterion, movie.country equals United States. I'm going to change the equal sign there to what SQL uses as not equal, which is a less than and a greater than symbol. I'm going to look at the results now. And what I find is the one 90s movie that is not a United States movie in our database at the moment. So that's our first look at queries. In the next section, we're going to look at queries and joins. So please join me for that.